A lot of protesters outside that school where a six-year-old was allegedly sexually abused by a staff member of the school. What we do see now is that there is a groundswell of protesters outside the school, the police trying to control them, and there are barricades being broken as the visuals are showing us. Let's go across to Pooja Prasanna for more. Pooja, over to you. What's happening on the ground?
We'll have to start marketing, cut to.
Pooja, if you can hear me, I wanted to know what exactly is happening outside that school in Bangalore. We are looking at some violent protests and police trying to restrain some of those protesters.
Well, absolutely. The protests here are turning ugly and violent. Several political parties have also jumped in and have gathered outside the school and are demanding questions, answers from the school management. As you can see on your screens right now, several BJP party workers have also gathered here with flags, and they're trying to break through the barricades that the Bangalore police have put up at the beginning of the road. They're trying to get closer to the school in an attempt to get answers from the management. Of course, since early this morning, heavy security has been deployed in and around the school. Several parents too would come here trying to get clarity in what's happening, were turned away. But what's ironic is right now, amongst the protesters, there are no parents. Earlier in the morning, there was another fringe group, Dalit Sangh, that was here protesting, and the police tried to contain those protests, and now more and more political parties jumping in, clearly trying to take political mileage out of the situation rather than trying to get any kind of solutions. Back to you.
Right. You know, Pooja, the larger question here is that this is a fourth incident within a month. It's no joke. I mean, we're really calling it the horror that seems to continue. But what is the reason for it? One must ask here, because this is appalling. And normally what happens is when one incident sets off an alarm, there are precautions taken. But in this case, what we see that, you know, incident after incident, it's just the same story. There are pedophiles on the prowl in Bangalore schools.
Absolutely, the fourth such incident in less than 4 months, and the second such incident in a matter of 10 days, clearly taking the city by shock. And what's more shocking is the attitude of the government, the chief minister, who still perpetrators and potential such people, but also to the schools who've been very, very lax about security. Even the school in particular, as we heard, the additional commissioner of police say a little while ago, has violated several norms that were put up by the commissioner of police a few days ago after the first incident. Several private schools did approach the High Court saying that the guidelines that have been given to them are way too much for them to abide by. And that case is still caught up in red tape. But the larger question is, if we can just show you visuals of what is happening. Everybody seems to be just passing the buck.
We have questioned him thoroughly, and very soon we are going to show the arrest of that person. He seems to be the accused in this case, but like formal announcement will be made later in the day at appropriate level, and other things like he'll be subsequently then produced before the court, and then 164 statement as per the POXO Act provision that will be in respect of like the victim, we will get it conducted, and other formalities whatever is there that we will take action with regard to that. And here we have come to see that what are the implementation about the guidelines issued by Commissioner of Police Bangalore City. So we have found that so many things which was meant to be implemented that had not been implemented till now. So we'll bring it to the notice of the Honorable High Court also, because the next date of hearing is on 7th of November, and definitely Honorable High Court will take a serious view about this thing.
Well, social activists have strongly condemned these series of incidents. Let's listen into what they have to say.
These are very unfortunate incidents, and all of these have taken place in private schools, and two of these by the teachers and one by the watchman, permitting the private schools for affiliation. At that place only, the security and safety measures for the students and specifically for the small kids. It should be ensured at the level of committees which are providing them the affiliation. And at the same time, there is a debate that in the primary schools, at least, there can be more and more female teachers.
देखिए ये हम लोग भी इस बात को कह कह के थक चुके हैं कि मानसिकता बदलनी पड़ेगी। मैं समझती हूँ कि मानसिकता बदलने की आवश्यकता तो है ही, लेकिन सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरी मैं सरकार से ये निवेदन करूँगी कि एक ऐसा कानून बनाएं जो इमीडिएट पनिशमेंट हो, ऑन द स्पॉट पनिशमेंट होना चाहिए, क्योंकि इस तरह से जो छोटी बच्चियों के साथ वारदात हो रही है वो भी स्कूलों के अंदर, जहाँ की बच्चियाँ सुरक्षित अगर नहीं होंगी स्कूल में तो कहाँ जाएंगे बच्चे। मैं मीडिया का भी बहुत, आप लोगों का भी बहुत शुक्रिया अदा करती हूँ कि आप लोगों ने इतने इन चीज़ों को आप लोग बढ़ चढ़ के बनाते दिखाते हैं, और सारे NGOs काम कर रहे हैं, सारे कमीशन्स काम कर रहे हैं, दुनिया के लोग का, उसके बावजूद भी इस तरह की घटनाएं रुकने का नाम नहीं ले रही है। तो इसमें तो अब तो यही एक चीज रह गई है कि ऑन द स्पॉट पनिशमेंट एक आना चाहिए, और सरकार को बहुत गंभीरता से इसके बारे में सोचना चाहिए।